running, no gunshots, but they getting low, 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 low.
Hey, what's up, guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another Thursday modding. So, in today's video, we're going to be working on a couple of Olivers here. These are public. You can find them on FS-UK and a few other mod sites. They're out there. So, they're really, really, really nice. Really great models. Only thing is these texture files. They all have spaces in them, and these specular textures are not right at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fix all of this stuff and make some changes to this tractor as well. If you look in the textures folder here, you can see I have a folder called original. These are all the original files. So what we're going to do first is we're going to open these up in Notepad++, and we're going to change, re-index all this stuff to go to where it should be. So we're going to get rid of all this specular stuff first off. So there's some specular. There's specular. Right there. Okay, you know what we're going to do is we're going to search for specular. Really, that's not going to help. Okay. So this is what's going to take the longest, is searching for all this specular stuff and deleting it, and then we'll just be able to go through and quickly change the indexing or the file path for this. So the reason that I'm just not using the original specular textures is because when you use them, they just turn the model black. So you definitely don't want that, unless you're in a place where your dirt is black or something. Who knows? Okay, I did delete the right thing then. But yeah, so, and I'm just going to use a universal spec map. So I'll be able to just use the one, and then I'm also going to change the cube map on here, so we can just remove the cube map line as well. We're almost done here. Wood specular. And then the cube map line. And then we should be all set. And I think these are actually exactly the same. So let's just go like this. Or wait. Let's fix this first. So original slash. Now we'll just take this. Control C, and then we just go way down this line. Control V. Control V. Oops. So the way that I'm selecting more than one line is you click where you want to be, and then you hit left control, left shift, and left alt. And then you click and hold, and then you just drag down. And then left control V, and you're pasting. So that's how you can select more than one line at once. That's really nice for here, you know, with changing many things at once. Okay, so let's save that, and then we'll just make sure. Okay, that was the 1955. It was not the cab version. Ah, shoot. The farmer I did not need to change. Farmer diffuse. He does not need to be changed. Anyhow, we can just look here. Okay, so now let's try this one again. I don't know why it's still showing everything black. Did it show up now? Doesn't look like it. No, it did not. Material editing? Yeah, it didn't. What the heck? Okay, I got a different way that we'll do this then. So we'll delete that recycling bin and we'll copy this. Let's go into a folder here. Rename it to Oliver 1955. Now we'll do this a different way. So we'll delete all this specular stuff. Spec. So we're deleting the farmer specular as well, because obviously we don't need the farmer to turn dirty. Because that would just be weird. Okay, so we can delete all that stuff. Okay, so all that we have is diffuses now. So we're gonna make a folder called new. And we're gonna copy everything except for triangle and farmer. And I just screwed up the way that this was set up. There we go. Control C, Control V. So now what we're going to do is we're going to delete color on everything. Okay, so I could not figure out why it would keep stop recording. I figured it out because of my hotkeys. The key for the underscore was also my key to stop recording, so fix that. Let's check. Yep. All right, that fixed it. Okay, so let's go ahead and keep renaming all this stuff. Axle joint diffuse. And he did not even spell window right on that one. I don't know why everything is so messed up on this. That's kind of annoying. And if you're going to release it right. So this I'm going to rename to weight diffuse. Actually, we're just going to put it like this, I guess. Briefcase weights. And you know what? I'm actually going to just get rid of diffuse. We don't need it. There may be a couple of things that I'll keep it, because there's a couple of things I have names very close, so I'll keep it on those, but unless it needs it, I'm getting rid of it because it's just extra wording. Extra wording that really isn't necessary. So like here, this one will be chassis diffuse and then the other one won't. So like this one will just be plain chassis. Although I really don't know what the difference is, but whatever. So this will be decals diffuse and then the other one will be just decals. Doors. So this will be dual underscore hub. So this will be engine, fan, front axle, front rim. So this will be gauges 2, this will be good underscore tire, levers, needles, new underscore grill. And this will be new underscore fenders. Old underscore muffler. Operator underscore stuff. Rear underscore end underscore stuff. This will be rear underscore tire. This is rear underscore rim. Rubber. And I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be screen. Seat. Spindles. Steering wheel. Top underscore link. Transparent underscore stuff. And then wood. Okay. So then I'm also going to get a new cube map. So cube map and then the middle speculars. And then this already has vehicle shader dirt. It just needs to be here. Okay, so now let's change this. Oh, never mind, we don't need to do that. Okay, so actually we are gonna change this. So window material editing is what we need. So this has the old muffler diffuse. So we're gonna go to new and we're gonna go to old underscore muffler and get rid of that. emissive texture. And then we'll go to textures and we'll apply the cube map. And bam, there we are. And we'll delete the light because we don't need a light when we import. And we'll save it. So now we'll start with the 1955 no cab. And then we'll move on over to the cab. Okay, so we need to put, come on, let me select this muffler. Okay, I guess it won't. Where is muffler? Screen. Oh, it's a, I did see a thing. Two, three, four, five, six. Okay, there is an info thing in here. 04011. Pipe. Oh, God. Well, that was embarrassing. Okay, so we're gonna import the old muffler. We're going to cut, paste into parts, and we'll take everything from here down to here, cut, paste, delete this, and now this should be 04011, and it is. Okay, so now we'll get started on all of this stuff. So, this has spindles. Okay, that one's already changed. We can remove the emissive texture, add the cube map. And add vehicle shader dirt. Okay, this has good tire. Remove that. You know what? We'll add the cube maps later. We'll go through and add all these textures first. So this is front rim. Because otherwise we're just sitting here going back and forth a lot, and I'd rather not. See, this one is already changed. That's already changed. That's already changed. So all of these really should be changed in... Okay, so now we just got to change the rear tires. Rear tire final, so... Rear tire. And we can remove that. Rear rim. So really it's not even changing the texture at all. It's just changing the name of the texture in a different way. I mean, I could go through and change them in Notepad, but... It's just kind of a little bit easier this way, I'll say. So. Yep, all that's changed there. So now. Let's see. Do I need to import the... No, I don't. Okay. I did delete that. Okay, I didn't. Alright, good. Good. Oops, wrong thing. So we don't need that, do we? No. But we do need this one. So this has 3-point hitch diffuse, which is this guy right here. Remove that. That's just all reference. This has 3-point already on it, and this needs 3-point. That's just all dummy stuff. Steering wheel. Steering wheel diffuse, obviously. So, this guy right here. Remove that. Hey. That's just all coronas. Yep, that's just a corona. Corona, that's all collisions. Okay, so now we get to work on all this stuff. Wait, this is just one weight? Wofta. Okay, so we got the briefcase weights here. Let me remove that. Ambers. So this is wood. This is axle joint. Wait, what? Axle joint, okay. Brief holder, brief attacher diffuse. And this is obviously going to be rear end stuff. This is a very nice looking tractor. That's for sure. Just has a lot of messed up stuff in it. I don't know why the guy didn't do it all correctly, but whatever. This will be levers. Rubber. Column. Triangle does not need to be changed because that's already indexed to the textures folder, so the muffler is also done. Briefcase weights are all done. Air cleaner. Screen. So this is gauges 2. And then this is gauges 1. Or gauges, I guess. This is operator stuff. That one's already changed. That's already changed. That's body. That's changed. Okay, this is that one. So this is decals. This is decals diffuse. Okay, so this has engine diffuse color 01. So, okay. Oh, there is only one of that. Okay. Front axle has front axle. That's simple enough. Seat is obviously going to have seat diffuse. Or seat is what I changed it to, I guess. Fenders new obviously is going to have fender or new fenders, whatever it is. Yeah, new fenders. Chrome, we're going to remove the cube map off of there. That does not have a texture on it. Fan obviously is going to have the fan texture. That's kind of a no-brainer there. Body 4, that has chassis. Chassis diffuse color, so I need to look here. It's chassis diffuse that we need. Clear stuff, that has the texture. Armor and brake. That one. Lights has transparent stuff. And finally, needles. Okay, indoor hood. Oh, we do need to change some of this stuff here. That's already changed, and that's already changed. Okay, so now we can go through and add the cube map. Which I did up here, didn't I? Yes. Okay, so we'll go through and add our cube map. And actually, what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to open up all this stuff that needs to be changed. Oops. So that way it's all done. Are all opened up. So now we can just go through and check. Okay, so we need to apply the cube. Oh, wait. I'm not applying cube map to the tire. I'm applying it to the rim. Tie rods and spindles already have it. So now we'll just go through and apply our dirt and everything as well. Apply all that as we go. And we'll get this thing done. Then we just got to go through and do the other one. Which I have a feeling that there's going to be an easier way to do that one. I'm just not sure. I'm going to try it and see what happens. Because I have a feeling I know what I need, what I can do on that one. But, like I said, I'm not positive. So we'll add the spec map to that. Okay, so now we have our rim, so we need our cube. Cube map. And then our dirt. And then the dual hub will also have that. Okay, so now our wheels are done. We'll add our cube map. So the cube map that I'm using is the default FS17 cube map. A buddy had sent it into a group chat that I'm in. And he said it looks really nice, and it really does. You can add it to just about anything and it'll look good, so. Anything except your tires, of course. You don't want to add that to your tires. Otherwise, that just looks ridiculous. So, we got all that dirt. So that our cube map to all of the weights, since it does them all, because they all have the same material. Bam. Got a rack of weights ready to go. And actually, what I probably should do right now is I should we'll wait, I guess. Okay, so that does not need spec map or cube map. Because your dash doesn't need to get dirty. Okay. Let's just open this up a little bit more here. Double checking that I'm still recording, because I know that it likes to stop on me. Cube map really lightens that up. That's nice. We'll add our specular to that. And then our XML and our specular. So let's see, levers, those don't need it. Rubber, that doesn't need it. Steering column, triangle needs it. Muffler needs it. That's already got the cube map on it. Or does it? Yes, it does. Okay. And then we'll add our spec map to it. Briefcase weights are all done. Now we need the screen. So the gauges don't need it. I don't know what that part is. Body 2. Okay, we don't need it there. Some places it doesn't look right. Others, it looks nice. And that spot is one where it does not look nice. So the row crop axle joints are done. Okay, so let's just see what the cube map's gonna look like on the tractor. I guess it is also in the way that the light's shining on it too. That actually looks pretty good. So then we'll get our spec added to it. First the dirt shader and then the spec map. Base, that's already done. Decals. Yes, that'll have the spec map. It won't have cube on them because the decals don't need to be shiny at all. But these ones do. Here, these ones will have the cube. Well, let's see. Well, let's just see what it looks like, I guess. Yeah, that looks okay. So the engine will have cube map on, I think. Let's just see. How's it look? Nah, it doesn't need it. Makes it a little too shiny. But it will definitely have dirt. Front axle will have cube on it. So I think with the other tractor, we will have to... oh, geez. I gotta take this bracelet off. With the other tractor, we'll have to go through and apply the cube maps and spec maps to it, though. I'm pretty sure. So, but that's no real big worry there. So the seat, that we won't have cube map or anything on. The person that did this tractor did do an awesome job on it, though. It looks great. I have not tried it yet because I saw the files for it and saw all the spaces and knew it was not going to be good. So the fan does not need cube map on it because it's kind of hidden away in there. So fan. Oh. I added it in the wrong spot. No wonder why I didn't get dirty. I was like, what? What's going on here? Does not work to apply your spec map as a cube map. So clear stuff is what? That. Okay, so why are you not going back down? Put that back at zero, I guess. Wait, huh? Oh, man. I wanted you back where you were. Not... Ugh, dang it. Okay. Let's look at the 1955 cab and see what it says for that. Parts, clear stuff. Oh, clear stuff. That one. Attributes. It is 3.192. Is what we need. Clear stuff. Negative 3.192. That's right where you need to go. Then we'll add our spec to that. Lights. I did okay. And then the needles won't have it, so there we go. That's it. We're done with this tractor. This tractor is completely done. So now we'll save it. Then we'll edit with Notepad++, and we'll go through and remove. So we'll select this, Control F, replace with blank. So now we'll just replace all this stuff, and that'll get rid of the new for us. And there we go. So now if we just copy all this stuff here. And paste it in this one. Although there is the cab in here, so we will have to change the cab, I think. But still, this will be a lot easier. Okay, let's check it out. And we do need to save this one. So let's just check the 1955, make sure everything's fine. Oh, obviously it's not going to be because we didn't move everything yet. So we'll select all this, so deselect that, and that. So we'll take all that. Put it in this folder just so that way we have it on hand. And we'll take all this stuff out of new and put it there. So we'll just delete that. Okay, everything should be fine now in here. Yep, everything's good to go. So now, if we go to the 1955 cab, everything should be all good here, too. Maybe. Shoot. It's not. Dang. So we gotta redo all of that again. But that's alright, I guess. Okay, well, we better get to work then and get that done. Okay. Oh, and of course I deleted everything. Dang. So now we gotta put everything back into there. So we don't need that, or that. Okay, good thing we kept everything. There we go. So we'll start off by putting on the new muffler, or the old muffler, I guess it's called. parts, and then we'll import the old muffler. Control X, Control V, Control X, Control V. There we go, and then we can delete that one. Okay, so why is the muffler? Oh yes. Okay, we need to fix this first. We need to change this to say, or actually what we can do is we can just change this to new. That's easier. So now if we go back, nope, dang. We gotta re-import it. There we have a texture. And then this should be 040. So this has to go down one. Or actually, let's bring back the old one. Okay, you know what? Let's just cancel that. And start over. Again. So we'll figure out what the node is for that first. Parts. Pipe. Where's pipe? Okay, so that was right. Alrighty then. So, there we go. Okay. So we're done with that. Okay, so now that we have this open, I wonder if we can move all this stuff. Is it going to... Oh, sweet. It's going to allow me to. Awesome. So that will make this go a whole lot faster. So this is good tire. Get rid of that. So now we can do all of this in one shot because now I don't have to go back and forth between everything. This is just going to be a whole lot easier. Front rim. Because now everything's where it's supposed to be. I don't have to re-index anything. And the muffler we can change as well. So we'll be all set. So the rim will have a cube map. Okay, so that's done. Spindles. Okay, so we got the fronts done, correct? Yes, everything's done there. So now we just need to do these rears. Rear tire. So then this is a rear rim. our spec. Definitely a lot faster now. Everything's a lot faster the second time. Three-point hitch. Get rid of that. Add that. So when you add your spec map, but don't add the dirt shader XML, it actually does not show up until you add that dirt shader XML in there. So that's done. So then we just need this part. Okay, and then that's done. Steering wheel we need to change here. And then we just go down to parts, and that's the last section that we need to be in. So, okay. So, we'll add the dirt shader XML. We'll add the cube map. Get rid of that. We'll add the spec map. And then we'll change the texture. Okay, that we just need to change this on. And remove that. No. Remove that. Row crop axle joint. So we got the grill. Just double checking that my headset's still on. I've done that a few times where I've left my headset off or it's died on me. And because I'm not playing something that has sound in the background, I don't notice that it shuts off. So when it shuts off, I'm just sitting there and I don't even realize anything's happened. So. Okay, so that's already changed. So that stuff's all done there. We're getting close to done. We're getting there. Slowly but surely getting there. Ah, shoot. Shoot, 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 shoot. There we go. Oh, I guess it wouldn't have mattered, really, I guess, now that I see it. Whoops. Wrong texture. Okay, so because this, let's see here, what all appears? Yeah, so because this is a closed cab tractor here, or a cabbed tractor, we won't do anything, any dirt. You know what, screw it. We're going to add dirt to it. We aren't going to add cube map, but we are going to add dirt. Yeah, that works. Operator stuff. Those are all done. Let that. Oops. This is okay up in this corner here. Let that. Remove that. Add that, and then that. Base. What's the base? Is that already done? Yes, it is. Okay, so this is the decals that needs this stuff added. There's the engine. Now we got the front axle. And then we will go in game and try it out. I'll load up a map with mud on it. And then we can just take a look at the tractor. And then check out the dirt and whatnot. And we'll be all good to go. So let's see, does cube map look good on this? Yep. Looks good to me. Oh, we forgot to change the texture on the door. Just realized that. If you forget to change the texture, You will be in some trouble. Oh, back window. Cab. Okay, so then this is just, oops, this one is just changing. I kind of wish that you could only have, like, that you could decide which side of the cab is dirty. That'd be kind of nice, but you don't want to just leave it clean because then it looks odd and, oops, I don't want a cube map on that. I don't know what I'm thinking. I just want the dirt. So then clear stuff. Oh yeah, that's that stuff. That is these thingies. So I don't need a cube map on it. I guess I don't even know if I added it on the other one or not. Then we just have our glass, and then we're done. We don't even need to change that one. Not adding dirt to the glass, because that would really look retarded. Okay, and then we'll save that, and we'll just make sure that nothing here says new or anything. Okay, everything is good there. So we'll just leave those. Okay. So now we gotta do it to these duals, too. So those can go over there. Whoa, I did not want all of that selected. Dual underscore rim. Rear underscore tire. So we'll start off with the left dual. Oh, man. Okay. So we'll just copy these. Paste them there. These can go, actually. There we go. So now we can put those in there. Okay, so now we can change this dual here. So this here is our rim. Okay, so we'll just do these parts first because It'll want to leave me at the, it'll want to leave me at the other thing afterwards, so, now we can do this. I guess not. Okay, cool. Done. So there's the left. Now we just gotta do it to the right. And then this tractor's done. Yep, there now we're in this spot. Okay. Oops, no cube map. No that. Okay, so now we'll change these. And just like that, we're done. We'll just double check these here in Notepad. That, yep, and it's a good thing that we did because, oh, actually that's gonna have to stay like that, okay. So, we should be all set to go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to zip this thing up. I'll get loaded up, and I'll see you guys in game. Okay, and we're back. No. We'll turn this down to 20. Off. Okay, so now let's buy these tractors. So you can see the Alice Chalmers 8030s that I had added selectable duals and weights to. That I had been talking about in an earlier video. Okay, any errors? Got a bunch of texture errors for other things, but nothing for those. Shoot. The dirt is not added. Oh, okay. We gotta make a quick change here. I did not add the line for dirt into these, into the mod desk and whatnot. So, let's do that quick here. Let's just take it off of the Alice. The mod desk and XML. So we need to start here. We need the washable line. Okay, and then I think that's it for the mod desk, yes. And then we need the XML files for these. Okay, we just need one line out of here. The washable dirt duration thing. And I don't want a dirt duration of that. Okay, this was set below all that stuff. It goes there. So the dirt duration is 30 that I want it set at. So we'll save that one. 30 is what I like my dirt duration set at. So we're going to update this as well. Okay. So now we need to go back to mods. And we also need to change that in this one. Because I like my dirt duration set at 30. Anything higher seems to just take too long. In my opinion. Okay. So now we'll zip all this back up. and I'll be back. Okay, so here we go. Why did it not update on that tractor? Okay, left alt 7 removes and adds the duals. It's got a nice sound to it too. It's got tire tracks, good. Although the front ones are a little bit off. So we'll add our duals back on. Looks really awesome. So now we're gonna go find a spot of mud. I'm trying to remember where the nearest one is. It's over here. Pretty sure that there's mud over here somewhere. Maybe not. Okay, I know there's some over this way somewhere. And it looks like the steering wheel did not get its texture applied or something, because I'm pretty sure the texture that it had is black. Not white. But I could be wrong. Okay, come on. Yep, there's some dirt. Or some mud, I guess I should say, not dirt. We'll never get out of this. So all of our lights work still, which is good. I didn't figure they wouldn't. Okay, there's really not a whole lot of mud here, so let's try and drive through it a few times. There we go. And just like that, the tractor is dirty. Okay, so we'll reset the rest of this stuff. No, not that one. I'll just show you guys these Alice Chalmers tractors as well. Just so you can see what they look like. See what I did to them. So if we fire this up and hit M, there go the duals. K, there goes the weight. This is the four-wheel drive version. It's got an interesting sound to it. Go over here and we'll test out the mud on it. Put our duals and weights back on. Take off our diff locks. Check out the mud on this thing. Dirt. It's nice and dirty. Okay, so we'll just check out this tractor, I guess. Yeah, the steering wheel didn't get changed on that one. Oh, the top link, too. Is that like that on this one? Yep, okay, so few more things to do to it, but nothing too major. It looks great, so can't open the doors or anything on it. I think my base down here is, so yeah, still a few things to change, but that's all that I'm gonna do for this video. You can see I got the duals and whatnot here too. But yeah, so that'll do it for this video, guys. I'm just going to make these fixes on my own here. Get them changed and whatnot. So, just got to fix the steering wheel, the top link, and the base on that other one. And then fix the dirt on the other one, and we're all good to go. So, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to check out down. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to my social medias, my mod site, as well as other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. My PC specs and upload schedule are also listed down there, so be sure to check those out. Yeah, thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.